Select your heroes.
I wanna take you for a ride.
Select your heroes. Select your system. Select your heroes.
Now, reserve my.
Select your heroes. Select your decision type. Select your decision type.
Yeah. big boy.
Shit like this, grew up poor, seen the door, and I couldn't resist. The smack dealer, the young homeboy is fucked up, thinking about the life side he stole.
When I drop this, I'm boy, it's time to go out on my piano.
With my last breath, it ain't checkers, it's chess. Knock you out on my left, take your life on my right. Blend in with the night. I know the whole my cup. We don't fight, rather shoot your breath or your coke right now.
Let's see.
I thought he was gonna quit. Most people with names like that, they'll rage quit themselves. There's a guy on Marvel 3 that was notorious for that. Yeah, I play Marvel 3. That game sucks ass online, though. I don't know what they did with that netcode. They fucked it up bad. By the way, can you hear me all right? Is this mic working good? Oh, that was sick. That was like some 8-on shit. Yeah, I played quite a bit of it, man. It's like, there's a lot of input delay, like, built into it. It's kind of sad. Because this game is better online. Street Fighter 4 is better online. Street Fighter Cross Tekken is better online. Like, it's just a matter of how much input lag there is off the top. I mean, it's decent. I played it a lot, but it's just, it's kind of rough. Yeah, I could see that. Because the game is actually pretty forgiving as far as inputs go. Kind of like Street Fighter 4. But not as bad. But yeah, if you played offline a lot, you would notice. And especially depending on the character, you would notice a lot. Like, one of the characters I play is Doctor Strange. And he's hella hard to play online. But then a character like Taskmaster, who I always play, or I also play... he works pretty well online. Like, his shit is pretty lenient as far as combos go. But some characters suffer a lot online. Magneto's another one. You want to learn Doctor Strange? Yeah, he's a pretty unique character. He's hard to play. He has serious mobility issues, but he's a cool character. I played him like right when Ultimate dropped, and I pretty much played him the whole time I played the game. I played Taskmaster and Vanilla the entire time. So those two characters I know really well. But yeah, I can see your team working pretty well online. Oh yeah, if you play offline, dude, you'll notice like a big difference. Oh shit, you're in here, man. Nice. Fuck, I'm gonna need a break pretty soon, but I'll play a couple more.
Change the game.
Oh, I didn't get it. Come in. Come in. Yo. Myself by push blocking. That's good, dude.
What's going on, man? Enjoying this rain.
Yeah, finally came up. I think it's supposed to rain for a couple days.
Yeah. I like this, like the this type, like this steady type. Nothing crazy about windy. It's like super light rain.
Oh yeah.
It's like not too, getting too crazy or anything.
Yeah, I've been over. Second, and just soaked head to toe type shit.
Yeah, basically. Like, I was almost started wild. I was like, I'm walking there, but I probably would have been. This would have got stinky, man. Fleece tight. Soaked in water.
Yeah. They dry fast, but they absorb fast, too. Yeah, I was just thinking about playing something else. I'm not sure what, though.
Okay. Yeah, man. I'm down to start. Every game, want to start a game or something.
Maybe do a two-player game.
Yeah. Get back on the base.
I know, that shit was fun.
Or Contra, too.
Yeah, maybe run Contra and then the base.
I should have brought Renegade. I might have the white people get by.
Oh, Renegade.
I just really want to play that game with two players.
You've already beaten one?
No. I know it's a two-player game, but I want to start that first game and run into it.
I guess Rand's trying to have some kind of gaming party or something.
Games told me about that.
Call me like 9 in the morning.
He called me early too. Blew up my phone. Yeah, I was supposed to. I don't know. I might go to the city tomorrow, but if the weather is worse than this, I might not go.
Just like this, I still might go. But I'll be back relatively early trying to go during the day.
Same here, like super powerful. And,
yeah, they could have done it. With Marvel 2, this probably wasn't what they were thinking, but I remember thinking, like, damn, if him and Iceman were in the game, then they would look hella alike, but.
Yeah.
It's not really a thing. I mean, there's two Wolverines. They would look almost exactly the same, so.
Yeah.
That's not really an argument. I remember thinking that, though. who knows, man? Could be a license issue or whatever, but it's like, he belongs, man. He's one of those super powerful fighters.
Yeah, dude. Galactus is like henchman. This is a lot. It's ridiculous.
He's in a lot of the Fantastic Four shit, right?
Yeah, he's like the main one of the main guys in Fantastic Four.
But he's a good guy, right?
Yeah. He's like, he was kind of, well, for the most part, yeah. Like later
he
on,
he helps the good guys, basically.
Right. But he works, he kind of like works for Galactus. And Galactus is not really a bad guy either.
Oh, okay.
In that aspect. He's like, it's weird. Like, he's not like Thanos or anything where he knows, like, he's just like trying to destroy like humans or anything. Like, Galactus, he's basically, he gets his power from like planets and stuff. Yeah.
See, like, that's what he, one thing he says,
like the resources, yeah.
This planet is born.
Yeah. He's like the Debo of Marvel Universe. Like, literally.
As much.
Like, yeah, like, oh, I need these resources. It's too bad there's like 6 billion people here. Oh, well.
Yeah.
I'm sorry. Like, it's not really, it's like not a personal thing. It's really weird with that. And like, Silver Surfer was a scout, basically.
Oh, finding the planets?
Yeah,
because
he's so fast. Like, he can get, like, be able to like travel galaxies like, because he's fast.
Hmm.
And so, he's like, because he's like way faster than Galactus. Galactus doesn't travel as fast. Or you can't.
So what does Silver Surfer get out of the deal then?
It has something to do with his planet. Like, he did a deal where, oh, he would, like, balance the resources with Galactus so he could save his people.
Oh, okay.
And he would be able to scout out planets.
Hmm.
And so Silver Surfer is always looking for planets that are uninhabitable that could still have resources. But I forgot what happened with the Fantastic Four. Something happened where it drew Silver Surfer, or Galactus drew something like on Earth that was attracting him, like one of the, some resource I forgot.
Mm.
And it's something to do with Doctor Doom also. He's very important with that too.
Oh, he was a part of that?
Yeah, super huge part of that. I'm not entirely sure I forget, but it's pretty tight. Yeah, Dr. Doom was actually, he was trying to get Silver Surfer's powers, I think, for a while.
Oh, Doom?
Yeah, he was like, he made like a device where he was, and he became super powerful for a while himself. Fantastic Four, they were, it's great. But I think they all ended up working together or something, like to fight Galactus or something. For the greater, you know.
Did anybody ever beat Galactus in battle?
Spider-Man. Like, literally, what? I actually have that comic, yeah.
Spider-Man, dude?
Yeah, Spider-Man by himself.
Wow.
He, like, in this comic in that universe, like, Galactus, like, basically killed everybody. Like, everybody, like.
On the planet?
Dude, like, no, just, like, I mean, he killed a lot of people on the planet, but I think, like all the superheroes.
Oh, okay.
Like, they all try to fight him, like.
Oh,
like, the
shit.
Comic I have, when you open it, it's just, like, X-Men are dead, Fantastic Four are dead, Avengers, Captain America, they're all just great.
Damn. He was, like, one of the last ones?
Yeah, he's like, one of the last ones. It's tight. It's, like, a 30th anniversary.
Do you remember how he did it?
Yeah. He used Mysterio. Remember, you know, Mysterio, the dude with the fishbowl?
Oh, yeah, yeah.
He used him, and he, like, tricked Galactus to, like, kind of, like, defeat himself.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, because Mysterio has, like, all these different powers where he can, like, kind of, you know, he's like a magician, you know, type deal. Where he has, like, a lot of illusions. So Spider-Man made himself look, like, super powerful, like Galactus. And it was crazy. He's sick, man.
Basically outsmarted him somehow?
Yeah, basically he outsmarted Galactus. That's usually, like, the Marvel theme. Like, all the bad guys are always too strong, right?
Uh-huh.
They're way too strong. Which is realistic. If they're that powerful, like, you just can't beat them. Like, oh. There's only been a few times where it's just been, like, collective powers and they beat them. It's always, they always outsmart the bad guy in Marvel. It's usually the case. Even with like Apocalypse, it was kind of like that. Damn, that kick is too good. Good, that was a good decision. You switched him out.
Yeah, I had to take the hit from Cable because it did two things. One, it was Cable's only meters, so now he has no meters.
Right.
And I saved Sentinel, so I have a DHC or the drones assist if I need it.
Yeah, which is very important. That's
very important. Because Colossus by himself against Cable is going to get chipped out eventually.
Yeah.
But if I have Sentinel behind, I have another option.
Right.
And I have easier ways to get in at Cable. Marvel decisions, dude.
Yeah, man, that's crazy. Yeah, he wants me to bring a setup, but I think if there's gonna be people over there, I'd rather bring my Dreamcast or VGA box.
I know, right?
I think that makes more sense.
That'd be hella cool.
I'll probably go do it, and it's less stuff. I do bring it. Ooh. 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 Man, this guy is going in.
Shit's happening.
I don't care.
Unblockable. I think Doom can actually get out of that too with his foot dive.
Oh wow.
Wow, it actually has one purpose in this game.
To get out of unblockable.
Get out of an unblockable. Good game, Keekon. Or Kickon. Whatever the fuck that is.
Big
gonna die, dude. One more time, fool. Let's go, that cable's down. Gave up.
Oh, man.
You never get up in this game. This Doom probably sucks. He's been playing Strider every game, but he never played Doom until then. And Strider Doom work well together, obviously. But man, you gotta try. Do this one and then the next one and then switch it out. Yeah, they're unblockable, dude. That shit is real. Too, but once you're in the corner, you gotta get out. Gonna run away so far.
Thank you.
shit went hella high.
That's random when it hits.
What?
Super, so you got him into a fierce, and then you did a super wave with.
You gotta time it. Like, how that super works is he goes up, and then he only goes down when you press down punch.
Oh, it's controlled, okay.
Yeah. So, like, you have to do it at perfect timing.
Yeah, I see what you're saying. So, your fierce, it doesn't knock him down, but when you did the super, you have to time it where it doesn't go over him.
Right.
Yeah.
Or under.
Oh,
like,
yeah.
It can go too
well,
early under.
Yeah, that's what happened. He went under.
Yeah. It's really hard to time, actually.
That's crazy.
Especially in the air combos. And there's a height restriction, so if I do it on the ground, I can't go down immediately. I have to go to, like, super jump height. But if I super jump and do it, then I can just go down. Like, I can just super and then go straight down.
Right.
But it's actually really hard to time, especially online. Like, one skipped frame at that particular point, then that's it.
Yeah.
It's that strict.
Oh, man. It's doing a lot of damage, though.
Yeah, it hurts.
That match is starting up for you excited.
They're
using all the weapons. They use the AUG and the grip. It was ridiculous. Fools were mad.
That shit's crazy.
Raging.
I just brought back my TAR 21 silenced.
Oh, that's really good.
Stupid good. And then
that's like the only weapon that can beat UMP. Silence, at least.
I might have saw you using it, but I brought back my AK too. I put AK extended mags.
Yeah,
somebody was using it.
I've used it.
I think it was you.
Yeah.
I was like, damn, this fool's getting off that shit. I forgot how good it is.
It's ridiculously good. FMJ is even better, but
you have to really
spare your shots because it's like wild, dude.
Yeah.
The FMJ is like two bullets. Rip.
Yeah, and I had that problem too. Fools were behind shelter, and it was taking some shots. That's probably what I should have done.
The extended mag, though, is a little bit better. Can you steady aim? I put on steady aim, too.
Wow. Just run up and some shit.
UMP, you're not going to know. You got to aim first. I'm already shooting. And I got stopping power, so I'm going to beat you. God, the game is too much.
You want to do a Modern Warfare game before we play the next?
Yeah, that's fine.
So I'm going to take a quick break anyway.
That's fine, yeah. Let's try it out.
Something happened to that controller where it has to be, like, plugged in now.
Oh, man. Sucks.
I mean, at least it works.
Yeah.
It's just I can't use it wirelessly. It's basically a wire controller at this point. I might as well just leave this in there at all times.
Yeah.
Really.
That's funny because I've always wanted that. I just always use rechargeable.
Yeah, dude, you don't know how many fucking batteries I ran through.
Yeah.
Probably like 30 packs.
For that much, like, I figured, like, I just ended up going to, I think I got a Walmart or something.
A rechargeable
double
A's, yeah.
They're just handy. Like, that's good for anything.
Yeah, it's not just for this. That's a good point. But actually, it's because of the fucking stick. Yeah.
But, yeah.
What actually sparked my interest, or what made me actually jump and grab this shit, was one of the Pepper Bellies tournaments they had. Remember one of the guys that ran it? I forgot his name. It might have been Chris or something, but he worked at Best Buy.
Oh, yeah.
And he did, like, a $25 gift card for the winner. And
won.
And I'm like, what the fuck am I getting a Best Buy? I don't need shit. And that thing was like $20. So it was like perfect.
Yeah.
And I was like, oh, this is awesome.
Yeah, I ended up using for Xbox One. I'm surprised Microsoft did that. Like, so the bottom part for your headphones, like, if you have like an older set, like, you can't plug it in, obviously, right? Like, like it's like new.
What do you mean older still?
So like this, yeah, this is, you can't, it's like a, it's like 3.5 millimeter, I guess. It's like a headphone one now.
Oh, okay. So you can use like any headset? Or
yeah.
No?
But no, there's a plug-in thing where you can use old, like, Turtle Beaches or old headsets.
Oh,
and that was like $20. It was totally worth it. It works really good.
Oh, so you use your Turtle Beach on
Xbox One now, yeah. I don't want to buy a new headset. I thought I was going to have to, like, kind of, like, count at that cost. But I was like, wait, hold on. They got this thing? It works?
That's what's up.
The ironic part is, I mean...